corn sandwich.
Tenderloin or ham.
Cold fried chicken.
Yeah.
Cold fried chicken.
Bacon sandwiches.
Talking about what lunch used to be like.
Oh, your Uncle Roy Crum and I were in the same class, and your Uncle Ron. And I grew up in Boylston, and we just had bologna every once in a while. I'd take bologna sandwich, and why Roy got hungry for bologna, I don't know. But he would trade me the home cured ham for bologna. About twice a week, we'd make that deal. I got the better end.
I like bologna too, maybe I got that from him.
Anybody not, did a parent not sign the form as you came up front? Some of them came in from the north side and they didn't sign that.
Everybody signed? What kind of question?
Yeah, we had wrestling team.
Wrestling team?
Even hockey, even boxing.
Where was that at?
It's up Cleveland, Ohio.
Cleveland.
We had quite a bit of hockey because being north, that was one of the global sports.
Sports.
Like, you know, basketball.
Basketball is down here.
Oh.
But most of this wasn't in school or after school, when did you do this?
It was after school.
Was it connected to the school, or you just did it on your own?
No, it was connected.
It was connected, it was scholastic, just like they have your league around here, you know, all high schools.
Was it mostly intramural or between other schools?
Between other schools.
Well, there used to be enough teams in the county, you know, that they could really play each other well.
Not be too far away.
Yeah, like, because all the little areas, you know, I call them, went just the other day, how many different teams there were in the county in Illinois. Consolidated, yeah, right.
And the school that my wife and I went to, one of the largest schools in the state of Ohio, had over 6,000 students.
6,000? Is that just in the elementary?
No, that was high school, just high school alone for the ninth.
That's a big school.
There was over 600 students in my graduating class, and over 800 in my wife.
Six, 800 kids, we have about 100 average, I think, here. Can you imagine having 800 classmates instead of only 80, like you have 85 this year? 800 in your class. How many sections was that? Was it divided up into homerooms or sections?
It's all divided up in homerooms. Maybe you had maybe about 75 to a homeroom.
75 to a homeroom?
You went to a different class because it was, you'd have auto shop and machine shop and carpentry work and electrical shop, printing shop, and all of those, whatever you wanted to specialize in. They had mechanical drawing. Students moved, yeah, the teachers didn't, the students all moved.
Okay, that's what we do here.
And we get out in the hall with 6,000 students like mad.
It's all 8 grades in my grade school.
8 grades in one?
School. 40 kids.
So just 5 and about a grade?
Something.
John?
My grandpa skipped a grade.
Did he? What grade did he skip?
I don't know, nothing in school.
Where was that?
They were about halfway between college and
Hi, come on in.
They used to have pitch-in dinners at Thanksgiving and Christmas.
They used to what?
Have pitch-in dinners at Thanksgiving and Christmas.
The students?
The students, and would bring a dish from home.
That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
It was quite a feast.
We used to cook a vegetable soup on top of the stove. He said, you gotta get the stove in the back of the room.
Your school had a big stove in it?
In the back of the room, we put a big pot up there and put vegetables in it.
And everybody ate?
Everybody ate vegetables.
And Liz is going, you are. Matthew?
What kind of furniture do you have?
What kind of furniture?
Just your school desk, where it's hooked on.
Hooked on each one of them.
The desks were hooked together, weren't they?
Yeah.
Of course, you put your energy in the
Surprise. Sit around here, just try to be a little bit more quiet. Day that you're seeing. And in just a few minutes, in the next, at a quarter till, we're gonna dismiss to our homeroom, and perhaps you'll see some of the things that we do in our homeroom. Right now, we've just finished up studying microorganisms, where the boys and girls look under the microscope and see small living things. We just finished that. And the next thing that we're doing is we're studying first aid. We will be studying fire prevention, because it's National Fire Prevention Week next week. We'll be studying fire prevention, first aid, and just safety of flood. And this is just a break in between the unit on microorganisms and the unit on fire prevention. This is the last day. They were looking forward to this day, so we're playing games today. Chris, put your names up. The high school has called the Young Astronauts Program. As you see, these posters all have the Young Astronauts logo. Every month, the organization Young Astronauts sends me information about Young Astronauts. They talk about toys that you can play with, so that you can learn something about science. They talk about things that you usually discard, that you could use to teach you something about science. The Young Astronauts motto is that every student should strive to better herself or himself in the science and math areas. We did a physical fitness program, and we did exercises that the astronauts have to do to be selected for the astronauts program. One astronaut program, I found out that the astronauts, you probably didn't know this either, that they have to live together for about a month before they send them on a space travel. Because if one person does something that really bugs all the other people, you know, there's no place you can go. So we talked about that. We talked about our good habits and our bad habits. And we found out that we all had some bad habits, but we all had good habits. We worked on three good habits and worked on one really bad habit that we wanted to try to eliminate. And we did that, and this board, we talked about all of our good habits, and this was the good habit side, and this was the bad habit we didn't get to hear a few minutes ago. And we've just been studying a unit on microorganisms. But I don't, what is a microorganism, I forget. Can anybody tell me? Yeah.
It's a small living thing.
And what tool do you have to use to see these small living things?
Microscope.
A microscope.
I can't get it to shut off, Ben. It won't stop.
I
I don't think so. I'll give it up.
Yes, if you're ready, as soon as you're ready.
Who's your name?
Thank you.